Nobody knows who you are up there. All his fans said they don't know who you are. Why don't you give us a little experience, a little background in your experience of your fighting career in Tulsa, kind of in that area?
Yeah, that's the crazy thing about, you know, whenever Tulsa fighting fans of some sort, they say that they've never heard of me, they must be fighting on the outskirts and some small shows at some old country land, like knocking old country land, because that's where I started, you know. But from the country towns to big time national television fights, that's where I've come to. I've, you know, I've had over 50 professional fights, you know, most of those being, you know, 37 fights in kickboxing. And you know, so I know myself in the ring, and then they say, you know, and that's another thing I said, just like you said that on, never heard of me. Well, I fought on Versus channel, I fought on HD Net, I fought on Showtime. So, and all the local television in Tulsa, I've been on it. Man, I can't tell you anything. Almost all my Tulsa fights have been televised in the state of Oklahoma, or in Oklahoma and around Tulsa. So either they didn't have a TV, they didn't have a radio, they don't have, obviously don't have no friends, and they're not really fight fans. You know, they might be this cat's friends, but they must not leave home, because you got to get out of town a little bit, which maybe just 5 minutes, they're gonna hear about it. They're gonna find out. All they gotta do is ask.
Well, of those, you said you had those professional kickboxing matches. How many years would you say that you fought in Tulsa? I mean, all combined, you know, whether it be amateur or anything, that's your old stomping ground.
Yeah, I fought 15 years in Tulsa. So I started on a small town, and after a while, when Dale Apollo Cook signed me on to his shows, my first fight was in, you know, first big fight was in Tulsa. And ever since then, you know, my manager and promoter did a great job on building me up and giving me great fights, giving me exciting fights, because I know the kind of fights that the fans like to see. They don't like somebody that's passive and wait and stick it. They want to see fights. So every time I go to the fight, win or lose, it's going to be a great, awesome fight.
Well, it leads me to another question about this fight. Do you see it as a fight? Do you see it as a boxing match? Do you feel like you could win a decision in the city of Tulsa with boxing referees if you fight this guy who's undefeated, who has, obviously he's got a lot of pressure on him, and he has all the pressure on him? I feel like you have nothing to lose in this. So what do you think? Do you think that you would have to go out and finish this guy in dramatic fashion, or do you think that you could pull a win off with a decision?
I think I can definitely pull off a decision. With a decision, with a knockout, with a TKO. And that's another thing, you know, whenever I called him out, this guy's 25-0 professional boxing. I've had one boxing match, but that was years ago, just to try it out kind of deal. Did well, but the thing is, I've competed in every game, and so I was like, well, then I heard about this Comanche boy saying how he's the top Native American boxer. I was like, well, all right, I'm going to find out if I'm everything that I think I am. Someone call this guy out and say, I'll fight on your terms. I'll fight on how many or every rounds as you want. I'll even fight up 15 pounds if I fight you. So come February 25th, if he doesn't punk out, he's going to get to experience me.
Well, you know that he right now is ranked 167th in the world. And the guy that the opponent he's about to fight is ranked 267th in the world. And that is his toughest competition to date. What would you have to say about that if you were 25-0 and that's some of the competition that you had fought? Would you be promoting yourself and self-promoting yourself to the extent that he is?
Man, he's doing a big step when he fights me. If the cats that he's fighting are that far down the podium in the boxing professional world, man, it's going to be a new world when he sees you.
What you want to say?
Comanche boy, you've been running your mouth a lot to somebody that's called a nobody on your side of town. Well, you know, it was all good. It's like just, it was all good until you had to run your mouth. Your little fans had to run their mouth about me, saying how I'm a nobody, I'm a chump. You know, I got nothing going in the fight game. I'm not close to your level.
Well, February 25th at the Hard Rock Casino 2011, you're going to get to experience that firsthand. So get ready. Don't be ducking me. Don't be pulling up injuries. Don't be wussing out on me. Because I want to put these knuckles all up on you. And you're lucky you don't get the rest of it. You only get to worry about two things. So I don't want to hear no excuses when you get caught with this one or that one, because it's going to happen. It's going to happen. So prepare for a war. Prepare for a war. Because I already got my mindset that I'm going to get one. When you get in that ring, your corner buddies, your coach, your friends, your posse, they can't help you now. Because once you stand across from a real champ and a real warrior, you're going to find that out. You're going to know at the end of the night, you just got in a fight. So, I will see you then. Train hard. Please train hard. And we'll see if there's nobody can give you a good fight. Because I guarantee you, I will.
Feels like these walls are closing in. This roof is caving in. But it's time to raise it then. You're tasing them with like pages in. My poker rhymes got them cooking, boy. That's cooking out of my mind. Got them all shook and scared to look in my eyes. I saw that clock. I took the time and I was came up from behind and pretty much snuck up in this game up. Better be careful. My name up. This fame that ain't up. I came to claim, but the game ain't gonna be the same on the day that I leave it. But I swear one day I'm not sure. I'ma make these haters believe it. I swear to God, won't spare the ride. I'm a man of my word, so your head's better not. I'm around in this and roast everybody. Sleep on me, that pillow is where your head alive. It's Benny Bob. This world is my Easter egg. Yeah, prepare to. My head is small, my confidence is up. The stage is my pedestal. I'm unstoppable, incredible. Hope you're trapped in my medicine ball. I can run circles around you so fast.
Dude, I mean, get your tickets. It's gonna be a show.